Good morning, grade six. This is Mr. Clement, your English teacher, and I have a good one for you today. We're going to talk about the poem Nothing Gold Can Stay by Robert Frost. One of my favorite little poems. It's only eight lines. Let's get into it. Now, Robert Frost is widely accepted as one of the most important American poets, especially of the 20th century. He was awarded four Pulitzer Prizes, which is the highest award you can get for writing, some people say, and more than 40 honorary degrees and fellowships from all of America's Ivy League schools. That's our top schools. He even presented a poem at President John F. Kennedy's inauguration celebration. So this week I provide you with one of the shortest and most beautiful poems in the American canon, Nothing Gold Can Stay by Mr. Robert Frost. As usual, your instructions are to study the poem, write an essay, post your essay to AS Blog Pals, categorize it appropriately, memorize it, and recite the poem in class. So study the poem. We're going to look at this into two parts. We're going to talk about the general understanding of the poem. Let me back out here so you can see how this layout is. The general meaning of the poem, and then which is right here. And then we're going to talk about some poetic devices, which we haven't done, but that's done in this area here. Okay? So let's get into it. I also have some advanced stuff, but we won't talk about that in this post. In this video post. So Nothing Gold Can Stay is a mere eight lines, but each line is packed with important poetic devices. Consisting of four simple couplets rhymed in iambic trimeter, the traditional rhyme scheme is and simple metaphors of Nothing Gold Can Stay make the poem easy for novices to read and understand. So a lot of students, when I showed them this, they said, "What's with these letters?" Well, these are indicating that this is a couplet because the A's tell us that the end of that line rhymes with the end of this line. And the B's mean the end of this line rhymes with the end of this line. So together they create a couplet, which is two rhymed lines. Nature's first green is gold, her hardest hue to hold. Her early leaf's a flower, but only so an hour. Then leaf subsides to leaf, so Eden sank to grief. So dawn goes down today. Nothing gold can stay. The general meaning of the poem is relatively simple. On the surface, the poem's general meaning is nothing gold can stay. In lines 1, 3, 5, and 8, Frost uses the change of seasons as a metaphor to imply that, let me back out here, that life's successes eventually and inevitably lead to new challenges. Nature's first green is gold, her early leaf's a flower, then leaf subsides to leaf. Nothing gold can stay. So we have the setup of the preciousness of new opportunity, and then the understanding that new opportunity eventually goes away. In lines 1, 2, and 4, Frost also urges the reader to appreciate those successes because they are precious and fleeting. So the setup, nature's first green is gold, first. And her hardest hue to hold, it's the hardest thing for her to do, and she can only hold it for an hour. A lot of students didn't get the general metaphors, so let me just go through this. Nature's first green, that's spring, okay? And there's the first sprouts of green grass, and it's gold being precious, okay? And hue is the color, and he's referring back here to the color green as being hard to hold. Green, of course, is referring to spring, so spring is the hardest season to hold. And her early leaf's a flower. Well, when spring comes, that's when our first buds start to happen. Before the fruit comes on the trees, we get the little flowers. And they only last an hour before they start to turn into fruit. So nature's first green is gold, her hardest hue is to hold. Her early leaf's a flower, but only so an hour. This is called a quatrain, four lines of an eight-line poem. Here's our second quatrain, and here we get a little bit more deep. The leaf subsides to leaf. This is now understanding, the reader, the speaker is now understanding that life does change. Life moves from leaf to leaf. And so Eden, paradise, where Adam and Eve started out, sank to grief. So dawn goes down today, nothing gold can stay. The last quatrain is the reader understanding, or the speaker understanding. That life changes, and those changes manifest themselves sometimes in difficulties, but change is inevitable. That's a general meaning. Let's look at the poetic devices. Poetic devices in Nothing Gold Can Stay. We're going to focus on three: the couplet, the iambic trimeter, and alliteration. What is a couplet? For our purposes, a couplet is two lines that rhyme. Couplets are very traditional, and according to some sources, are immature and a bit outdated. While Shakespeare and Chaucer used couplets extensively, postmodern poets such as T.S. Eliot, Ezra Pound, would find greater freedom in more complex designs and free verse. This guy was a fan of the couplet. I do not like them here or there. I do not like them anywhere. Rhymed couplet. I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like them, Sam I am. Another rhymed couplet. Dr. Seuss often employed couplets, which made his children's books both accessible and fun. Moving on to iambic trimeter. According to Wikipedia.org, iambic trimeter is a line or meter of poetry consisting of three iambic units per line. Well, that doesn't mean much. What does that mean? Well, in poetry, an iambic unit is a metric foot, one unstressed and one stressed syllable. So, let's think of it as one da-dum. So if I'm looking at a poem with trimeter, I'm looking for, tri means three, I'm looking for three iambs per measure. That would be three da-dums. So da-dum, da-dum, da-dum. Her hardest hue to hold. Da-dum, da-dum, da-dum. Her early leaves a flower. Da-dum, da-dum, da-dum. But only so an hour. Then leaf subsides to leaf. So lines 2 through 7 are perfect iambic trimeter, and I've color-coded the iambs here, the feet, if you will, the metric feet, so you can see that there's three stressed and unstressed syllables per line, three iambs, and the stressed syllable is in bold. Interestingly, lines 1 and line 8 are not perfect iambic trimeter. Line 1 is backwards. You get the dum da, nature's, nature is where the stress is, nature's first green is gold. And line 8 doesn't even have three iambs. It has half an iamb, no, and then two after it. Nothing gold can stay. Nothing gold can stay. So the fact that both the first and last lines of the poem contain augmented or imperfect iambic trimeter is a bit troubling. Some scholars believe Frost erred in these lines, while others believe that they were broken on purpose. You do not need to make a judgment on that to respond to the essay questions. But for those who are advanced readers, I have a whole bunch of more on it below. Alliteration. How alliteration binds the poem. Well, alliteration occurs when the author repeats a sound two or more times in a line. Bobby's basketball backboard broke. Right? It's alliteration. B's. In poetry, we go beyond just looking at a repeated letter or sound. We look for a sound that is on the stressed syllable. So if Nothing Gold Can Stay, Frost uses alliteration in several lines. The fact that he can utilize alliteration and keep his iambic trimeter rhythm is quite a feat. Nothing Gold Can Stay contains 5 lines with alliteration on the stressed syllables. Lines 2 and 7 contain perfect alliterative elements on the stressed symbols. Hard as hue, hold, HHH, dawn, down, day, DDD. These lines respectively introduced and conclude the poem. Thus, they have a binding effect on the poem. What does that mean, they have a binding effect? Well, if we look at, let's go back up to the actual poem. Hard as hue to hold, dawn goes down the day. So it's like everything, all the meaty parts are sandwiched between these two perfectly alliterative lines, and that they both have the same DDD and HHH alliteration. So that is about alliteration of the poem and how alliteration serves the poem, this binding effect, and that's at the beginning and the end, the introduction and the conclusion of the poem. Advanced readers, I'm not going to go into this. I'm going to make a separate post for advanced readers, and I'll stick it inside of these drop downs. But you do not need to understand the information contained in these sections in order to respond to the essay's writing prompts. I have included them because some readers may find the information helpful and interesting. Though Nothing Gold Can Stay is a mere 8 lines, it has generated a huge amount of critical response. I have compiled 4 brief essays below. Each one of these are for advanced readers. The True Theme, Felix Culpa. Couplets, the perfect countermeasure to the Felix Culpa theme. Broken Iambic Trimeter, lines 1 and 8 bind and recycle the theme. And Alliteration, How is a Poem Like a Hamburger? And each one of those essays can be found within these drop downs. So if you drop them down, you'll see the essay there. And you're welcome to get into that or not get into that. You do not need to know any of that to write the essay. Usual rules, adhere to MLA formatting. Your title is the title of the poem by Robert Frost. Don't forget the punctuation is important. You must identify each sentence with the following abbreviations. Formatting will be just as like previous assignments in that you will put a punctuation, a space, and then the abbreviation. So IC for independent clause, CX for complex sentence, CD for compound sentence, CDCX for compound complex sentence. And your essay needs to address the following questions. Here are your writing prompts. What is the general theme of Nothing Gold Can Stay? And how does Frost use metaphors and symbols to express the theme of the poem? How does the general theme of Nothing Gold Can Stay apply to our everyday life, or your everyday life, or anybody's everyday life? And the fourth one, where I want you to think a little bit, some scholars believe there's a positive message in Nothing Gold Can Stay. Do you agree? And please explain your response. So if you don't agree, explain it. Posting your essay to in a copy of the poem to AS Blog Piles, it's the same steps we've been doing in the past. You're going to title it Nothing Gold Can Stay by Robert Frost, except for your quotation marks going to go the right way automatically. Same categorization. Paste your essay as plain text. When you paste the poem, do not use paste as plain text. Center the poem and make the title of the poem bold. Your featured image is the image titled Nothing Gold Can Stay of this lonely tree on a hopeful yet dark day. And publish your post. Memorize the poem. Now, this week's poem is only 8 lines, so memorization shouldn't be a problem. When you are memorizing the poem, please focus on rhyme and rhythm. Da-da-dum, da-dum, da-dum. While the poem is only 8 lines long, 2 quatrains, as we say, Nothing Gold Can Stay is remarkably deep and sublime. So please listen to the example videos provided below. Take time to really understand the words and give them meaning when you speak them in class. Here is your rubric. Here's how you get a perfect score. Do these things and you will have a perfect score. We've been seeing some very high scores, and this is a very good way to keep your grade up, or to get your grade up. So take your time, memorize it, and kill this poem when you come in. Here's the poem one more time. Notice that there's not these 4 lines, it's not broken into stanzas. These are just talked about as quatrains, but it is just 8 lines together. So this is exactly how it should look when you paste it into before you publish it, I should say, in AS Blog Piles. Make sure you center and bold the title, and the rest of these should come over just like you see them here. Shining examples. Here's actually Robert Frost reading Nothing Gold Can Stay. You can hear his actual voice. Here's a Pony Boy from The Outsiders. I know many of you are reading The Outsiders, and this poem is featured in the book as well as in the movie. Here's some high school girls doing it, and it gets pretty interesting until at one point there's a cow in the video, and I'm not sure why the cow is there. Here's a nice stop frame animation of the seasons changing to help us understand, I guess, what this reader believes Nothing Gold Can Stay means. And of course, we have the ubiquitous hippie, because we are talking about poetry, and my, how the hippies love poetry. You can listen to his version of Nothing Gold Can Stay put in the song. If you have a question, ladies or gentlemen, put it in the comment section below. I look forward to hearing from you. Take care, and Masalama.